Hi, everyone. So thank you for the invitation. It's really my pleasure to be here. Last time I've been in Ukraine, it was in 1993, a long time ago. And if I tell you that last time I went to Russia, it was still SSSR. Yes, I'm that old. Okay, so today this talk is going to be about iEx.ec, which is a project of doing a blockchain-based distributed cloud platform. So I try to make it easy for everyone to understand. I'm a scientist, I'm a research scientist at INRIA. So if it gets too technical, just, you know, I will try not to be too technical. So yes, INRIA, it's one of the main research institute in Europe. We are more than 3,000 working here, distributed all over France. So it's a big group. And this is actually a spin-off from my research institute. This is a startup we are starting with some friends. So, okay, this is the crew. My partner is Professor Hai Wuhe. He's at the Chinese Academy of Science in Beijing. And he's with CENIC. CENIC, it's the institute that manages all the supercomputers in China for the CAS and also the networking. I have some good old friend, Mircea and Oleg, they are scientists. And we've been working together for more than 10 years. We are in Beijing also. We are incubated by the accelerator from the Tsinghua University. So this is our pride, as you can imagine. And all those developers here have been recently recruited, and most of them are really specialists around blockchain. My background is really about parallel computing and distributed computing, modern blockchain. And of course, we grew the team to have people in, you know, doing marketing, PR stuff, etc. So, what's the idea of iEx.ec? You know the cloud, of course. You know what the cloud is. Okay. So the idea is to decentralize the cloud, both from a business perspective and from an infrastructure perspective. We are infrastructure guys. We love the machines. So we are interested in network and machines. So the idea is that we're using the Ethereum blockchain to create a global market for computing resources. Okay, think it as a sort of Airbnb for servers, for applications, and for data sets. So you would have the users. Users, of course, it can be applications, can be developers, going in this market to rent the machines they want, the application data sets. Okay? And so you, as a, with my, do we have miners here? No? So the same way that people, you know, use machines for mining, they will be also able to monetize their machines for executing applications. So the objective is to create this distributed cloud, and in this marketplace, you're going to have computing resources, so mainly servers. We are going to have storage for data. Well, it's more data access than remote storage. Also application, so it's like software as a service or platform as a service, for those we know, and services deployed as container. So for which application, this is where it gets interesting. What kind of applications are going to be able to use this cloud? The first one are what we call the dApps, the blockchain-based distributed application. So I don't know if here we have developers for Ethereum, for instance. Yes, so you know what I'm talking about. When you develop for the blockchain, you have very limited capacity. Okay, really few kilobytes, and the storage is extremely expensive. It's extremely slow. There is a virtual machine. It's like programming a smart card. It's not like programming a supercomputer. They claim it's a supercomputer, but it's not. So here, with iEx.ec, all those applications are going to be able to go off-chain and get their resources for their most demanding, you know, for the most demanding applications. Once this distributed cloud is going to be established, it's going to be very competitive compared with centralized cloud, because you're going to have a large number of resource providers. And so here we can imagine that existing application will move to this specific infrastructure to get better performance and better price. So we can imagine that legacy applications, the one that exists now, in particular those who are very demanding in terms of raw computing power, simulation, 3D rendering, biomedical research, would go to this distributed cloud to get better price for their execution. And last but not least, I think it's the more important one, it's what we call the emerging distributed application. So these are the applications for which we know that the cloud as it exists now is a bottleneck. So here, think about, you know, stuff like Internet of Things, for instance, which are very distributed and which in the future are going to produce a lot of data. And moving the data between your device and the centralized cloud, et cetera, is going to be very complex. So they will need some sort of new infrastructure, new kind of infrastructure to exist. So actually, this idea of distributed cloud is something real timely. At the moment, what happens is that there is a huge concentration for the data center. So the trend is to put all the data in the same place, and so data centers are becoming bigger and bigger. And so they are always, I mean, providers are looking for location for the data center where the electricity is cheap and there are free cooling. And because of that, the data centers are located farther and farther from the data producer and consumer. And so decentralizing the data center, it has a lot of positive consequence in terms of energy efficiency and data location. So just to give you some examples so that you can figure out. So these are partners we are working with. What you see here is new form of data centers. So this heater is actually a server. These are the processors here that generate the heat that is warming the apartment. It's a startup in Paris called Cano Computing. Here, the same idea. These are servers, and this is a furnace. So the servers are warming the water before the water is being distributed in the building. And here, what you have, it's a parasol project. It's done by Rutgers University. This is a data center which is located on the rooftop. So you have solar panel, battery, and here it's a strong arm processor, so like mobile phone. So it does not consume any energy from the power network. So you see this idea of decentralizing the data center, it actually makes sense. But of course, so we are going to build this market network, and indeed this market network for computing resources, the very interesting thing which makes it very different than the centralized cloud computing is that we're going to have a lot of different resources. So the one that I just talked about, okay, and also GPU mining farm. So that's very interesting. Here I'm not talking about the Bitcoin mining farm because Bitcoin machines, you can only use that to mine Bitcoin. But for instance, for GPU computing, so those who are doing Ethereum mining, they have GPUs, and those GPUs can be used for something else than mining. And they can be used, for instance, for doing machine learning and this kind of thing. And so that was quite interesting because this year in November, we were at SC. So SC, it's the supercomputing conference. It's really a big conference, more than 10,000 attendees in the US. And this is where you have all the supercomputer manufacturers, you know, Cray, IBM, etc. And for the first time, we had a miner, I won't give you his name, located in Germany, attending the SC, and we made this connection between people from, you know, supercomputing and miner. And this is a program we are launching. It's quite interesting. It's what we call the energy positive worker. So this is a very small kind of miner. So it's a worker. This is our terminology for mining. And it's a little ARM processor with a little battery and a little solar panel. And so this is also fully autonomous. And so what is interesting is that you have this choice of all those machines in one single marketplace. So this is what I call ultra scalable system. You can choose, you know, your target machine either according to the performance or to the geolocalization or to the latency or to the energy. Energy is related to total cost of ownership. Here, TCO is extremely low for the energy positive worker. So this is something really totally unique with respect to traditional centralized cloud computing. So the origin of the technology, this is what we call desktop grid computing. So this is the idea of using idle PCs on the internet to execute parallel applications. You may know that under the name of volunteer computing, Boeing, SETI at home. Does it ring any bell? No, nobody knows that. So it sounds a little bit exotic, but that's actually a very mature technology. It's been there for like a decade or even more. we have all the advanced features we need to create this distributed cloud, like security, virtualization, QoS. We use that on many applications. In particular, as my research team, we work on establishing the European desktop grid infrastructure. This was funded by the EU. We got four EU projects to do that. So we published something like, we co-published as a team more than 80 scientific papers on this topic. So this is something we know very well. So here we are interested in, we are using two software, one that is called XtremeWeb and Bidu. So XtremeWeb, it's a task scheduler. It allows you to provision computing resource on the internet machines to execute some task. Okay, so we deploy the application, execute the task, move the data, and so forth. And Bidu does the data management. That's very important because all those applications have super high requirement in terms of that data. So you must do that very efficiently. We did a proof of concept. You can visit it if you want to play with that. And so here, the idea of this proof of concept is to show that, yes, we can, through the blockchain, provision some computing resources, like a cloud, okay, execute applications. So if you're familiar with Ethereum and MetaMask, I mean, with Ethereum, you know, it's like using a traditional application. You send the tokens, and we do the computation. So this becomes a little bit technical. So if you allow us, you would ask me some questions after that. So here, what we do is that we generate a vanity Bitcoin address. Who knows what is a vanity Bitcoin address? Okay, maybe you have some. So here, it's a Bitcoin address that starts with a specific pattern. Sorry for your loss. Don't send money here. Okay. So typically, this is the kind of application that you cannot execute on the blockchain, in particular on the Ethereum blockchain. So you have to go out of the blockchain to execute this application and get the result, and get the result back to your smart contract. So yeah, we did that, but not only that, of course, we also supported existing scientific application. At the moment, we're playing with artificial intelligence. We're playing with Stockfish, if you know that. You can play against a chess engine through your smart contract. So this is our test bed, how we design, develop, and evaluate iEx.ec. So for this, we're using the Grid 5000 infrastructure. It's something established by the French government. It's quite big. It's quite unique in the world. We are very lucky to have this. And what you see here is the prototype working since December. And we do some reliability test, scalability test. So we used up to 3,000, a pool of 3,000 nodes. And what you see here, so we're doing this in partnership with Steamergy. And these are the actual servers, and we execute our application on those machines. So I'm almost done. So, of course, we have released the white paper. If you want to, so this is the website. If you want to read the white paper, I encourage you to look at this. We have a very clear roadmap for the coming years. So in the roadmap, what is important is that we have something very progressive, and something where we try to be, we try to have very clear go-to-market strategy. So what we are first focusing on, it's the distributed application, so what we call the dApps. And then we establish a lot of, you know, what we call enterprise feature, because we have a good knowledge of what the enterprise needs if they really want to access a public cloud like this. It's going to be a little bit different than Amazon. And in this roadmap, we also address high performance computing. So how can we use all those GPUs to actually perform other kind of computation than traditional mining? And also some more advanced feature that we call the research edition. So if you're interested, I encourage you, talk to me and maybe have a look in this white paper. Okay, as a conclusion, you know everything about this iEx.ec distributed cloud. We're going to release our token and organize a crowd sale for that in less than 1 month now. So our token is the token that can be used to access this infrastructure. So if you're interested in ICO and this kind of thing, you can also talk to me.